हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू बोधनपमीनास चैनल। हियर इज अ गुड न्यूज़ फ्रॉम आईबीपीएस फॉर बैंकिंग एस्पिरेंट्स। आईबीपीएस हैज रिलीज्ड इट्स ऑफिशियल नोटिफिकेशन फॉर द रिक्रूटमेंट ऑफ प्रोबेशनरी ऑफिसर्स और मैनेजमेंट ट्रेनीज to fill nearly 1417 vacancies in the 11 participating organizations for the year 2021 and 22. Last month, it also released its notification to fill the vacancies in rural regional banks. Let us see the tentative calendar of events for the recruitment of IBPS PO. Online registration including edit or modification of application by candidates can be done from 5th August 2020 till 26th August 2020. Payment of online application fees or intimation charges can be done from 5th August 2020 till 26th August 2020. Only online applications are accepted and no other mode of application is entertained here by the IBPS PO. And the last date for online registration as well as payment of application fees is 26th of this month. And those who are eligible for pre-exam training can download their call letters in the month of September 2020. And this pre-exam training will be commenced from 21st September 2020 till 26th September 2020. And the aspirants, the applicants can download their call letters for online preliminary examination in the month of October 2020. The tentative dates for online preliminary examination will be conducted on 3rd, 10th and 11th of October 2020, and the declaration of online preliminary examination result will be there in the month of October or November 2020. And download of call letters for main online examination will be there in the month of November 2020. And online main exam will be conducted on 28th November 2020. Declaration of main results will be there in the month of December 2020. And those who have been shortlisted in the main exam, they can download the call letters for their interview in the month of January 2021. And interviews will be conducted in the month of January or February 2021. And at last, the provisional allotment will be done, those who have been cleared the interview, in the month of April 2021. So these are the tentative dates, friends. Later, the dates will be communicated to you by the IBPS. So these dates may vary or may not vary. Now let us see the 11 participating banks in the recruitment process for the year 2021 and 22. Bank of Baroda, Bank of India, Bank of Maharashtra, Canara Bank, Central Bank of India, Indian Bank, Indian Overseas Bank, Punjab and Sindh Bank, Punjab National Bank, UCO Bank and Union Bank of India. So these are the participating organizations, and total we are having 1417 vacancies. The examination charges for IBPS PO is as follows. In case of SC, ST and PWD, there is no application charges. They have to pay only for intimation charges, that is 175 rupees they have to pay online. And for general and others, they have to pay 850 rupees online. It includes both the application charges as well as the intimation charges. Let us see the eligibility criteria. First one is age. The reference date for age is 1st August 2020. So the minimum age required is 20 years and the maximum age is 30 years. So the people who fall between 20 to 30 years and who have done graduation are eligible to apply for this PO. And a candidate who have been born before 2nd August 1990 and after 1st August 2000 are not eligible to apply, but these two dates are eligible for applying. And there is age relaxation for SC and ST. There is 5 years of age relaxation, and for BC there is 3 years of age relaxation. Age relaxation is applicable according to the norms. Let us see the educational qualifications that are required. The candidate should possess a degree from a university or institution recognized by the government. And the next one is, the candidate's final result should have been declared on or before 26th August 2020. And the third one is, he or she should possess proper document from board or university to declare that or to show that the result has been declared on or before 26th August 2020. The date of passing the eligibility examination will be there on the date appearing on the mark sheet or provisional certificate issued by the university or institution. In case if the candidate has a web-based certificate or the result has been posted on the website, then the candidate should produce a proper document or certificate in web-based which is duly signed by the appropriate authority indicating the date of passing properly mentioned for further process. And the next one is, the candidate should calculate the percentage obtained in the graduation to the nearest two decimals, and they have to mention the same in the online application. If CGPA or OGPA is there, they have to convert the same into percentage and indicate in the online application. During the process of interview, the candidate have to produce a certificate regarding the university norms in conversion of CGPA to percentage and the percentage of marks scored by the candidates in terms of norms. The next one is, how to calculate percentage. So aggregate marks obtained by the candidate in all the semesters or years divided by aggregate maximum marks into 100, we can obtain the percentage. Let us see the recruitment process of IBPS PO. The selection procedure consists of three stages. The first one is preliminary exam. Those who have cleared the preliminary exam will be called for the main exam. And those who have shortlisted in the main exam have to attend the interview. And those who have cleared preliminary, main and interview will be allotted in different organizations. Let us see the online preliminary exam pattern. This preliminary examination consists of three sections: English language, quantitative aptitude, and reasoning ability. And there will be a sectional time limit also. And each section will consist of 20 minutes time. And English language will be there only in English, whereas quantitative aptitude and reasoning ability will be available in both the languages, English as well as in Hindi. So English language will be there for 30 marks, and it consists of 30 questions, and they have to answer within the time limit of 20 minutes. And the quantitative aptitude, 35 questions will be there, 35 marks will be there, and they have to answer within 20 minutes. And the reasoning ability, 35 questions will be there, 35 marks and 20 minutes. Within 20 minutes, they have to answer. And there will be total of 100 questions for 100 marks, and they have to answer within 60 minutes, that is 1 hour time. Let us see the main examination pattern. The main exam will consist of 5 sections. 4 are of objective type and 1 is descriptive type. Reasoning and computer aptitude, you'll get 45 questions from that section and for 60 marks, and it will be there in English as well as in Hindi languages, and you have to answer within 60 minutes of time. And the second section is regarding general awareness, economy and banking awareness. 40 questions you will get, and it is for 40 marks, and you'll get in both the languages, English as well as in Hindi, and you have to answer within 35 minutes. English language, 35 questions, 40 marks, and you have to answer within 40 minutes. Data analysis and interpretation, 35 questions you will get, and it is for 60 marks, and it will be available in both the languages, and you have to answer within 60 minutes of time. So total 155 questions for 200 marks. And after this, you have to type descriptive paper in English. You'll get 2 questions, one is letter writing and the other is essay, and the maximum marks is 25, and you'll get 30 minutes time for typing this essay and letter writing. Let us see whether the penalty of marks will be there or not. Penalty for wrong answers. So 1/4 mark is deducted from the score obtained for each wrong answer. So no mark is deducted if it is not answered, or if the answer is left blank, or if the question is left blank. Let us see the differences between IBPS PO and IBPS RRB PO. Level of examination. So IBPS RRB is a bit easy when compared to IBPS PO. English language is absent in the preliminary examination of IBPS RRB, whereas IBPS PO consists of English language also. And if you take the time, there is a composite time for RRB PO, but here there is sectional cutoff. Sectional time limit is there for each section. So friends, prepare well and good luck for your examination. Thank you friends for watching, and stay tuned for more updates from my channel. Please watch, share, subscribe my channel. Have a nice day.